What's good, y'all? Coming at y'all with another Halloween movie list. This list is different than the one I did yesterday. Yesterday was a little more lighter in tone type movies. Today is all about the gore. So if you like blood and guts, these are the movies for you. If you want something to watch Halloween night, check these out. Starting off the list is Hereditary. This movie came out earlier this year. It stars Toni Collette and Gabriel Byrne. I know a lot of people haven't seen this movie yet, and you probably was wondering, hey, should I watch it or should I not? It's definitely worth your time, even if you just watch it once. It's a great-ass good horror movie, very suspenseful. It's about witchcraft, sorcery, some exorcist-type stuff, you know? But yeah, it's a great movie. I give it an 8 out of 10. Definitely worth your time to check it out. Next up is Fright Night. This is an old-school movie, came out in 1985. It stars Chris Sarandon, William Ragsdale, and Roddy McDowell. It's basically about a young kid. He thinks his neighbor's a vampire, and so he enlists this old vampire hunter guy from TV, and they go investigate, and pretty much all hell breaks loose. It's gory, but it's really not over the top. I mean, some of the stuff you'll laugh about now with the effects and everything like that, but it's a good one watcher in case you wanted something old school. Next up is Evil Dead. Now this movie is really gory. It came out in 1981. It's a trilogy by Sam Raimi. This movie stars Bruce Campbell as Ash. He basically is in every Evil Dead movie. This movie is about these teenagers or these youngsters. They go to this cabin and they read this book of the dead and they make the dead come back to life. And it's just over the top, crazy and gory. So yeah, definitely worth a watch. Next up on the list is Hellraiser. This movie came out in 1987. It's about Pinhead himself, played by Doug Bradley. It's basically a story of this box. This little, he was tinkering with this box and it opened up a portal to this other world where Pinhead and the Cenobites, you know, those are people that are with him, them crazy looking folks. They're called Cenobites. Well, they came out with him and basically it's a lot of gore and killing and slashing in this movie. But yeah, definitely worth a watch. So the effects and all that great, but still, it's a good movie. Next up on the list is Saw. This movie came out in 2004. This was a great, you know, start to what end up being some bad movies later on. But this first movie was really good. It was really different. It starred Carrie Elwes and Leigh Whannell. About these two gentlemen stuck in this, I guess you want to call it a locker or a freezer or something. And they're chained to these poles and they can't get out. But you would think that would be boring, but with all the connections and backstory that go into it, it makes for very suspenseful. It is blood and gory, so, you know, if you're gonna be a little churning the stomach, you might not want to watch it. But yes, yeah, a great movie, great start. Even the first two or three Saws was pretty good, but this the one that kicked it off and I really liked it. So yeah, it's definitely worth a watch. Next up on the list is Silver Bullet. This movie came out in 1985, stars Corey Haim, RIP to him. He plays Marty, and Gary Busey plays his uncle, Uncle Red. So yeah, this movie is about a werewolf is going around this small town killing folks. And Marty was able to do a little detective work and figure out who it was based on a scar he had gave to the werewolf when he attacked him. And he found out in town who had that scar and he ended up killing a werewolf with a silver bullet. But yeah, it's a great throwback movie by Stephen King. You know, a lot of stuff Stephen King does is just completely just, you know what I mean? He's the horror king. And actually, I got another movie from you by Stephen King. It's called Pet Sematary. This movie came out in 1989. It stars Dale Midkiff and Denise Crosby. They basically play a couple whose son died and they bury him in this cemetery that's pretty much close by the pet cemetery. But anything you bury around this area comes back to life. You know, your pets, your loved ones mostly. And yeah, they bury their son there and their son comes back to life and all hell breaks loose. It's a really creepy movie, but it is some gore in there, but it's a very good horror movie. If you want something to watch on Halloween movie night, this will be perfect for y'all. Well, anyway, y'all, hope you enjoyed that list. I hope you got something out of there you wanted to watch. Maybe something you ain't thought of or seen in a while. You want to go back and give it a second watch or, you know, something like that. But yeah, let me know in the comment section if you like any of these movies or if you already seen them, what you think about them, or if you're going to check out something this Halloween night that I recommended. Let me know if I helped you out. Anyway, y'all, don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel. It's much appreciated, y'all, trying to hit 1,000 subscribers. So if you do like and subscribe, I do appreciate that. Thank you very much. So I'll catch your ass out there in this universe. Peace.